Hello students, welcome to Laexcellence. Welcome to the 55th weekly magazine where we will be covering from 12th March to 18th March 2018. Now in this magazine, there are several issues which are important from this year prelims, but some issues are there from mains point of view also. I know this is a peak time for you to focus on prelims rather than on mains, but I'll just try to tell you what it is so that you can mark it separately and after prelims you can use them, right? But mostly I'll try to show you those for prelims which will help you to recollect better. The very first important thing is about the annual survey of India City Survey, right? Nowadays you are seeing so many reports released by different people and the analysis of these reports are being made. You never know government considers which report and government will not consider which report. Because of that, sometimes what happens, UPSC may ask a question from those reports accepted by the government and they may not give prominence to those reports which government is not in a position to accept it. Now given that, let us talk about the quality of life in cities. Now this index, where can we use it? Will they ask you what are the things that we have to consider? No. You know that urban areas have lot of issues today. It is believed that by 2050, more than 50% of Indian population may be staying in urban areas. If that is the case, we are going to see lot of pressure on urban areas, whether it is in terms of water, food grains, land, electricity, governance, money, roads, sewage plants, all this becomes an issue. So at this point of time, this service will help us to write in mains essay or in questions when it is about the urban areas. The first thing we need to ask when we look at the urban areas is, does it have a proper sanitation plan? Most of the cities, we are talking about Swachh Bharat Mission, where we are focusing on constructing toilets, but urban sewage is still a dominant issue. And the state governments have not made any significant plans to address them. The gases which are coming out of these garbages are also creating lot of trouble to the human health. The second important thing is about the green buildings. It may be color, it may be the plants and other things that you are planning to grow. It may be about the solar panels that you use. If the houses are constructed according to that, is the city or government providing any sort of incentive for them so that they will continue that? Is the second question. Third, how is public participation in preparation of city or local body plan? That is in governance. What is the role of the local people? Next, what is the percentage of revenues to expenditure? That is it dependent on devolution of funds or is it dependent on its own earnings? We know that in India, economic survey clearly says that in urban areas, the direct tax collections for buildings and all are very less and they are almost 40 to 50% dependent on devolution of funds. Whenever they are dependent, the problem with devolution of funds is they have to obey what the government usually tries to tell them. Next, is the staff adequate to cater to the population? Whether it is with respect to urban governance or in several service providing, is the staff enough or is it less? What is the average tenure of the commissioner? It is very, very important, mainly because whenever the commissioner and all keeps on changing, whatever targets is given to them, they may not achieve. Whenever they don't achieve, they start something and move out. You cannot ensure accountability of anyone. is a serious issue. Does the council have a final say in approving the budget? The meaning of this is, the councils, whichever is being formed, can they approve the budget on their own, or they have to depend on the state finances? Does city have adequate gender representation? You know that in India, certain reservation is available, but not everywhere. If you go to Nagaland and all, urban areas, they are not being given adequate representation. So that needs to be seen. Does city publish e-newsletter? That is about what is happening, where transportation is there, like, you know, where which problem is there, all this. The meaning of this is whether they are communicating with the public effectively or not. Has the position of ombudsman been filled, that is the Lokpal and others? Does the body have single window civic centers like e-seva kendras and all? Does the city conduct citizen satisfaction survey like global happiness index? On these basis, if we see, Pune has performed better. Bangalore has not performed much better. It is one of the worst affected cities. So these are some of the issues that you need to focus when we are talking about annual survey of India's city survey, right? So after this, let's move to the next issue. We know that Ram Setu is one of the most important socio-economic issue in India. UPA government had said that when you look at the Ram Setu, this is usually present in between Gulf of Mannar and Park Strait. And whenever you try to have a navigation path here, then that would actually help in reducing the distance between this particular coast of Tamil Nadu. Else, you have to go across Sri Lanka, which is becoming a bit costly. And the other important thing what the government says is, if at all we have to make these portions as hub, global hub, then that is possible only when you have this channel properly. Big ships can come only at that particular time. But Supreme Court has actually said that we want government to respond whether they want to destruct it or not. But the government has said that they don't have any intentions to change this particular course. Prelims question can be with respect to the shortest distance between Sri Lanka and India. Please try to read that. Second important thing is actually with respect to, like, you know, the Gulf of Mannar, Park Strait, fishing, coral reefs, all this present in this region. Supreme Court has actually given its case with respect to passive euthanasia. So this article is more about the things which we are going to see in future. The article expects that several things, wherever technology is there, the Supreme Court may take similar actions, is what it tries to predict. But my simple point is, until and unless other legislations come up, don't try to give your own justifications. As of now, focus more on passive and active euthanasia. You know that special category status issue is there. Last week, I have clearly explained what is special category status. Now, when you look at this, whom to be blamed? 14th Finance Commission has not said that you should not have special category status. But as Planning Commission is not there, the relevance of it has been removed. But this continues, right? So just focus on what we saw last week rather than looking at these issues. The French president's visit to India clearly shows that the relationship is improving. When we talk about Indo-French relationship, unlike other countries, other Western countries, Indo-France relationship is mostly associated with science and technology. France is one country with which we have naval, air force, and military exercise as well. You know, there are several countries, but France is also one such. Like Russia also has. France also has. So, India and France have very good relationship when it comes to science and technology, defense, military exercises, Rafale deals and all. Clearly shows that the relationship between India and France is much better. And when you look at the nuclear reactors, the Areva nuclear reactor, which is being constructed at Jaitpur, this France was the first company or first country to have agreements with India immediately after 123 agreement or NSG waiver, which India actually obtained. Right, guys? So because of those things, these are important. Indo-France, mostly from mains point of view, not from prelims. And when you look at space, France helps India to build rocket launching station, liquid engine development in most of these, including renewable energy. And you know that International Solar Alliance, which India planned, was also inaugurated along with the French president. Right, in that was under the Paris summit. So all this becomes important. I have already told you about this Mahanadi Water Disputes Tribunal. This year it is very, very important, as it is occurring at this point of time, high possibility Mahanadi River, right? Where it originates, where it goes, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, Jharkhand and West Bengal, right? Tributaries of Mahanadi, all these issues become important. And interstate tribunals or water disputes tribunals are also important this year. Again, try to see this once, right? But most importantly, from geography point of view, my request used to study Mahanadi River in detail. The next important issue is there for prelims. MILES 2018, it is first ever multi-nation naval exercise which is held in the Andaman Sea, right? It is part of Milan, where the countries will come and participate in the naval exercise. Now, when you look at this, the theme of this is friendship across the seas. Which are the countries which participated? Australia, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Malaysia, Myanmar, Singapore, Sri Lanka and Thailand. Can you see? You have almost South Asia and Southeast Asia, including Australia, has participated. Please remember, China is not part of this. What will it help in? Rescue operations against piracy. Like, you know, whenever they have to work together, all this is usually seen. The next important issue is ICC. This year, high possibility you may get a question on ICC. Mainly because several countries are withdrawing from ICC. This criminal court is actually trying to say which countries are not following human rights and which countries prime ministers or presidents are leading to human rights violation. Now, when you look at this, Philippines is trying to withdraw mainly because there is a case coming up against Philippines for their actions against the drug mafia. So they are planning to come out. In earlier articles, I have clearly mentioned what is ICC and all. In the prelims roundup, again, I'll be taking up ICC. But here, I want you to know that ICC is very, very important this year. You must be aware that the budget is passed without much discussion. And when you look at the constitutional terminologies and all, you have a term by name guillotine, which means after a particular period of, like, you know, 3 weeks or 4 weeks, if the bill is not passed, rather than discussing, they close and they put everything for vote and it is said to be passed. So now these type of things are observed because the country has to run and the opposition parties and the government is not coming together to discuss on the issues. So the government is passing. So the terminologies may be asked, right? You know the issue, but the terminology is asked. What is the impact of this on governance is mains question, where you have to discuss that it is the power of the legislature to make executive accountable, and if discussion and all doesn't happen, the meaning of this is legislature is not doing its work properly, all this comes into picture. Next, Ministry of Sanitation and Drinking Water is awarded for implementing e-office, where everything is in this, in the internet format or e-platform, and the projects are done under Digital India, right? So you just need to know that almost all the ministries are entering into online, like, you know, where everything is going to be transparent over a period of time. The next important issue is about the program launched by Union Health Ministry, that is Lakshya. And the program is aimed at improving quality of care in labor room and maternity operation theater, aimed at reducing the maternal mortality rate and also take care of infant mortality rate, right? It is under the National Health Mission. So it is looking at stillbirth, breastfeeding, maternal mortality, morbidity, all this comes into picture. When we look at this program, it is an initiative to improve the quality of care in the labor rooms, right? The initial time is very, very important to ensure that maternal mortality or infant mortality is reduced. The program aims to implementing fast-track interventions for achieving tangible results within 18 months. That is, institutional deliveries, if we have to improve, then the only thing that can be done is by providing Anganwadi centers at every place and give 100% coverage, so that it would be easy to monitor. And also, whenever you go for computerizing each one of this, there can be monitoring at different levels as well. A multi-pronged strategy has been adopted, including infrastructure upgradation, as I told you, ensuring availability of essential equipments, very, very important. In most of the centers, equipments will not be available. Even if equipment is available, electricity will not be available. Providing adequate human resources, because absence of Anganwadi workers and all will be an issue. Capacity building of healthcare workers and improving quality processes in the labor room, right? So there is Lakshya certification, a healthcare facility achieving 70% score on, like, you know, they will give several factors like, are these equipments available, institutional deliveries, how much, like, how many people came, have you done the follow-up. On the basis of all this, you are going to get Lakshya certification. Once that is there, like, you know, that is a type of motivation. Like in the private sectors, you do motivation the same way. Even in the public sector, you need certain motivation that would actually help and also give certain incentives to the Anganwadi workers who are actually working. Global Happiness Index, right? The report shows that Finland is top, right? So it is actually developed by United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network. The first report was in 2012. Not so important, just try to see once. TDP has actually come out of the NDA and it has passed no confidence motion. And you are aware that the government, they, after this issue, there are a lot of crises, no discussion. Every day there is something or the other, and the session is also prorogued. Now you have to know what all will happen whenever the session is prorogued, which bills will come to an end, impeachment, all this. So that is important for you, right? If prorogue, like if there is anything happening in the session, if there is, when we call, like, you know, a significant time period, there is a break, then what is the issue? If there is completely, like, you know, stopping that particular session, then what is the issue, right? All this you have to read in detail. You know that International Solar Alliance is the most important one, mainly because its headquarters is in India, proposed by India. Paris summit actually helped in this. And what is the aim? Within the tropical countries, whichever is there, they are coming together and they will make a fund where India is contributing for these countries coming together, and everyone will work together to ensure that investments is made in production of solar panels, techniques, energy, and R&D, patents, anything associated with this, so that that will benefit all the countries which are present within the tropics. And this will help the world move towards renewable energy and their dependency on the fossil fuels or coal-based power plants will be reduced. New Zealand has joined Clean Seas campaign, where the campaign is mainly aimed at removing the plastics, making the beaches and all more human friendly, right? You have to ensure that cleanliness is maintained closer to the seas so that littering is completely avoided. Marine littering is avoided. To study the arsenic which is actually present in the groundwater level, especially as you have Ganga River, whenever the Ganga floods or the water level raises above the flood level, usually the, like, you know, the water will seep down and it carries the arsenic and all. So UK and India are coming together to study about this arsenic which is present in the groundwater, right? Very important, arsenic in groundwater. From prelims point of view, whenever these type of issues come, UPSC will easily ask a question about arsenic. Now, what is the issue? Arsenic containing groundwater is hosted by sediments deposited by rivers during the late quaternary. Incidence of high arsenic in groundwater reported from various parts. So now they are trying to see whether it is there along the Ganga River or not. Arsenic occurrences in groundwater is highly sporadic in nature, and all the sources in these areas are not necessarily contaminated. So first they are trying to see where they are actually present, and if there is any problem, we are planning to ensure that through remediation measures at the aquifer level, we are going to remove the arsenic. You know that in Syria, like, you know, Russia, many places, there is use of chemical gases, like, you know, whether it is in an incident to kill the North Korean president's relative, use of sarin gas, now use of notorious VX gas. All this again makes CWC, that is Chemical Weapons Convention, important this year. Please try to focus. India was and today is one of the major player with respect to Chemical Weapons Convention. Any question can be asked. We have already discussed about this in previous sessions. So please try to go through that carefully once. The last important thing is actually about the cold fusion, right? India is going to adopt this. What is cold fusion? Cold fusion describes a form of energy which is actually generated when hydrogen interacts with various metals like nickel and palladium. Now, when you look at this, it is a field of condensed matter nuclear science, right? And is also called low energy nuclear reaction. You may also call it lattice assisted nuclear reaction, low energy nanoscale. All these are actually part of this. Not required, these are all technical details. But what is important for us is, what is the advantage? No radioactive materials are used in the cold fusion. So you need not be scared that this would actually lead to nuclear accidents or so. And whoever is opposing the nuclear reactors in those areas, if we can go for this, and if once it is economically exploitable, then it would be very important for us. It occurs as the tiny protons, neutrons and electrons of hydrogen interact, releasing energy slowly through heat and photons without the dangerous radiation associated with conventional nuclear reactions. So the energy received can be trapped and used rather than relying on the nuclear reactors. So guys, this is important for us. So, as I keep telling you, you have to look at the criticism as well. What is the criticism? Cold fusion seeks to produce nuclear energy without complex equipment and the application of very high temperature and pressures. But it has no conclusive theory explaining it. There is no guarantee that if you invest in this, you are going to find. Several research is going on, but no one is able to find. So, is it worth spending so much money on that? You always know that there will be criticism in India whenever you focus on areas which are innovative and you want to work on them, right? So just try to know what is cold fusion. That is important for prelims, nothing much. So guys, after seeing this, as I keep telling you, ethics questions and all, please keep them. After prelims, you can write it. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.